Hello, welcome to lab. Today we're going to be doing limiting reagents. I'd like you to be my lab partner, and I'd like you to follow along in your lab manual. The first three steps are a lot of weighing. First, we'll need to weigh some copper chloride dihydrate, which is in the back balance room, and put it in our beaker. We'll also need to weigh a square of aluminum foil and our evaporating dish. Let's go to the balance room. Now that we have our copper chloride dihydrate in our beaker, step four says to add about 30 milliliters of DI water. And kind of swirl to dissolve it all. It should dissolve very quickly. If there are any large chunks, you can break them up with your stirring rod. But everything just went into solution. Now in step five, we're going to take our aluminum foil and I'm going to tear it into four pieces. And then I'm going to make a very loose ball with each of those pieces. And I'm just going to let that sit for about 3 minutes. Now you can actually see that there's some copper forming on the aluminum foil. Now this reaction will go as proceeded here, but we'd like it to go a little bit faster, so we're going to put the aluminum foil in solution as aluminum 3 plus ions with hydrochloric acid. And once you get the aluminum in its ionic form, it reacts much more quickly with the copper chloride. We're going to watch this for a little while, and we're just going to wait until all the bubbling has subsided. Now that our reaction is over, I'm just going to swirl the beaker gently, maybe tap it a few times on the lab bench to get some of that copper to settle. And sometimes you'll have a piece that just doesn't want to settle. I've got one piece in here that doesn't want to settle. It will later. And we are going to decant about half of this. And here's a technique. This works great at home, especially in those measuring cups that always have a dribble down the back. If you'll put, we're going to put a stirring rod in the little pour spout of the beaker. You can use a knife or a spoon at home. And we're going to pour out, I've got that one piece of copper that just wants to stay. We are going to be pouring out about half of our solution. And you can direct it with the stirring rod where it needs to go, but this is good. And then in step 9, we're going to add about 30 milliliters of DI water. Again, the amount is not terribly important. Kind of toward the sides. And we're just going to let that settle again for a minute. Looks like it's very well settled now. And we're going to decant almost all of the liquid, or the supernatant, that's another name for the liquid on top of a solid, into this beaker. Now I'm going to be repeating this step about 9 more times, so 10 times in total, before I tested the pH. We're trying to get the pH of this solution very neutral. We're going to be heating this later, and we don't want to be heating a solution with acid in it. Okay, I'm going to decant. This is my 10th time. Getting rid of almost all of my supernatant. And we'll fill it up again. And this time we'll test the pH. One thing I really need to stress, we're going to go over correct pH testing technique. Sometimes students have laid their stirring rod in the beaker, and this has contained that 20 milliliters of a hydrochloric acid. And when they go to test, it's always very acidic. Let's be sure that you rinse your stirring rod off before you test your solution. So this is my solution. I'm going to dip my stirring rod into the supernatant and then touch it to my pH paper. and that is just fine. The pH is probably about 6 right now, which is above 5, and we can continue with our process. All right, in our next step, we are going to transfer all of this. First, we'll decant a little bit and then transfer a little bit more this to the evaporating dish that we've already weighed. We have some very nice copper in here. And we'll use the rubber policeman which is a fancy name for a spatula. Get that in the evaporating dish. And then I'm going to use a little bit of DI water and rinse my rubber policeman off. Get any copper that was on there. And then there's quite a bit of copper left in our beaker. We're going to use our squirt bottle and kind of get it in there. Make sure that if anything else on the outside, we get every last molecule of copper that we can see. And I think we've got it all. Beautiful. And now we've got our copper with some water in our evaporating dish. Now we're ready to heat our sample. But the first thing we're going to do, you can see that this is not at the right height at all. We're going to adjust our equipment before we get the heat on. And I'll probably 2 or 3 inches above the top of the Bunsen burner is good. And then we will light our Bunsen burner. Again, we'll shut everything off. Both our air and our gas. We'll connect our Bunsen burner to the gas supply. We'll open both the gas and the air one full turn. I do not hear it because I have not turned it on. And then we'll light it. That's super high and super yellow. We're going to adjust the flame to a reasonable height, and then we're going to add some air, making it a beautiful blue flame. And now we can place our sample and carefully watch this so that we don't overheat it. We're going to heat this to dryness and maybe 30 seconds, a minute, not more than 2 minutes longer. Otherwise, our copper will turn into copper oxide. And this will take a little while. Most of our water has been evaporated now. I'm just trying to put a gentle flame underneath it, drive off almost all of the water. You'll start to see the copper lifting off a little bit from the bottom, changing color a little bit, so it's a little bit brighter. You don't want the black. That would be forming copper oxide, which is not the intent of this experiment. It's just to form copper. Now that our copper sample appears to be dry, we can shut off the gas at the source, and then we'll use our hot mitt to remove our evaporating dish to the bench top so it can cool. Now that our sample is completely cool, we can go reweigh it at the balance. Now you can calculate a percent yield and answer the error analysis questions. You can also clean up, please, so the next group will be ready. Thank you for being my lab partner today.